Welcome to Art Loft. Tonight, artists reinterpret what was once considered traditional. But first up, two murders and two suicides in three acts pretty much sums up the family dynamics in Mourning Becomes Electra, the tragic tale of family relationships gone awry. We met up with the members of the cast and the play's composer during their collaboration with the Florida Grand Opera. Take a look.
You'll be seeing an opera that took me 6 years to write, called Mourning Becomes Electra, based on the O'Neill adaptation of Aeschylus, which was based on another play, The House of Atreus. So it's a complex lineage. However, it's worth it. You'll have a headache by the time you're finished.
Actually, I'm the only person who's ever sung this role outside of the world premiere in 1967 at the Metropolitan Opera. When the opera was revived in 1998, I did that production. And when it was revived in Seattle and in New York City, I did the same role in those productions as well. So I think the composer is slightly superstitious that he won't get a good show without me singing the lead character of the mother. So, you know, I love the piece, so it was an interesting idea to come back and do it again.
I've had the great privilege and pleasure of singing this role before, 10 years ago. So it's quite luxurious to be able to come back to a contemporary piece a second time, because we just come with so much more confidence and so much more to be able to feed the character.
Well, I'll tell you what you cannot expect is an easygoing family situation. Although it is a family, but it's a very complex structure of a family that involves all sorts of hatreds and murder, incest, a little bit only.
I play the role of Christine Mannon, the mother of the story. The mother is someone who's quite powerful, you know, really struggling with the marriage that she made, which was marriage to a powerful man, but a man who was firmly, I would say, rooted in the past, in memories of the past, in honoring the dead, and she's really much more about life. While the husband is away, my character falls in love with someone who turns out to have close ties to the family, and who originally comes back to the family in order to revenge a part of his own story, and then falls in love with my character. My character is mostly a murderous meanie, for want of a better word. I say she's in love to a fault. How about that?
What can you say?
My character is Lavinia Mannon, the daughter, but in fact is the Electra of the title. She's the one seeking vengeance for the murder of her father. Lavinia is actually somebody who early on, and for a big part of the opera, is completely, she's almost like in a straitjacket, because she's so busy keeping it all together, and she's so repressed, and so such a control freak. And it was interesting, because I found one of the biggest challenges was to do that physically, because when we sing big dramatic stuff, there's a tendency to get expansive with the body. And so in order to sing that dramatically and to stay very contained is a particular challenge. And I think one that will definitely carry through here, because that's one of the key elements of her character, is she is so incredibly repressed until the moment she's not anymore, because there comes a very key moment in the opera where all of a sudden she is not repressed, she's completely liberated. And to be able to make that contrast, we have to play with the physicality of it.
Modern American musical writing is difficult. It's usually very rangy, it's demanding in the way that Puccini and late Verdi can be very demanding. But it's in English, which is a much more difficult language to sing in than pretty much any other language, including Russian, which is quite difficult to sing in. There is this sort of very large challenge of how do you keep this music sort of beautifully inside your voice the way you would Verdi and Puccini. So that right away is quite challenging.
There are very few plays, very few in the repertoire of American plays that give you the opportunity to write such dramatic music. It's like a storm from the beginning to the end. And so is the opera. The opera is like a storm. It doesn't stop. Even the players in the pits, they're happy about it because they're kept busy all the time. They don't stop for a minute. And I've given them a lot of notes.
For information on this and other productions from Florida Grand Opera, log on to fgo.org.